It was the spring of 1948, and the world's top physicists converged for a conference in the Pocono Mountains. Included among them was the brilliant bongo-playing physicist, Richard Feynman. One of the biggest problems in physics was describing quantum interactions in a way that's consistent with Einstein's special relativity. The possibilities and potential problems seemed endless. Feynman presented a simple diagrammatic scheme for keeping track of and calculating the particle interactions. That's it. These powerful tools in physics became known as Feynman diagrams. After World War II, physicists wanted to further develop the theory that explained electromagnetism, why like particles repel each other and opposite charges attract. This theory, called quantum electrodynamics, or QED, attempted to calculate the probabilities of all possible outcomes of particle interactions. But there were two seemingly insurmountable problems. First, writing down the equations meant keeping track of all possible particle interactions, including virtual ones, a grueling, hopeless exercise for even the most organized and patient physicist. Second, when quantifying the scattering amplitudes, the probability for how particles come together, disperse, or transform into other particles, the calculations break down, producing infinite values. Feynman's 1948 diagram was a simple visual way to account for and ultimately quantify all the interactions. Think of this Feynman diagram as a story of a particle interaction in space and time. The straight lines are particles of matter, like electrons, and the wavy lines are particles that convey forces, like photons. In this simple interaction, two electrons scatter. Let's rotate this diagram. Now the arrows are pointing the opposite way and represent positrons, or anti-electrons, moving and exchanging a photon. Each section of the diagram corresponds to part of a QED equation. The stories of these scatterings begin at the in and out states of the interaction. Across those points, energy, momentum, and charge should be conserved. Things get a little weird in the middle since these intermediate virtual particles can disappear and even go back in time. This means that any number of bizarre interactions could happen in this space. There are infinitely many possibilities for how a particle interaction can occur, but Feynman diagrams allows you to chop off the possibilities and calculate the result at whatever level of precision you want. When Feynman first introduced his diagrams, his peers remained perplexed by how to use them in their own work. Fellow physicist Freeman Dyson translated the diagrams into mathematics that researchers could understand and work with. He also showed how infinities could be converted into finite values through renormalization. Soon, the diagrams were everywhere, transforming modern theoretical physics. But after a time, their limitations became increasingly evident. When it comes to collisions of subatomic particles like quarks and gluons, thousands of diagrams are needed to calculate the relatively simple scattering amplitude. Some physicists are now working on a geometric approach for scattering amplitudes, called the amplituhedron. It all started at that 1948 conference in the Poconos. Feynman diagrams helped unlock the underlying physics of our universe on the smallest scale. Thank you.